I can understand that people may think I'm a bit crazy. I am happily be crazy and be focused.
Simon was on his own defending himself. I saw Capilano's lawyers and they walked in with these suitcases and the files were stacked halfway to the roof. And it was in that moment that I thought, wow, this is a David versus Goliath situation.
I'm just defending myself. So if I think I'm telling the truth and they're not, of course I'm going to have to fight it out to the end.
Many Australians were surprised recently to find out that the honey they've been buying might not be 100% pure.
Capilano supermarkets accused of selling fake honey.
Capilano, Australia's biggest honey producer, and supermarkets accused of selling fake honey.
Capilano denies fake honey claims as supermarkets pull certain brands pending further investigation.
A recent investigation by a foreign testing lab using methods not used in Australia revealed some honey sold in Australian supermarkets had been bulked up with cheaper syrups, including Capilano's Alawi-branded mixed blossom honey. But there's another part to this story. Capilano's attempts to silence a man who has been trying to sound the alarm for years.
I'm disgusted with the behaviour of Capilano Honey. They've spent millions of dollars trying to shut me up when they could have spent millions of dollars on doing the appropriate testing. G'day. Yeah, it's Heath, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I've just got a few jars of raw honey there for you.
Beautiful.
Simon Mulvaney is a small-scale beekeeper and since 2014 has been alleging that honey produced by the country's biggest producer, Capilano, isn't the real deal. That's landed the single dad in a legal battle against a honey giant worth about $190 million.
How long has this gone on for? How long have Australians been buying honey that actually hasn't been honey?
Simon's honey crusade started from a desire to solve the loneliness that came with being a single dad.
I set up a Save the Bees Australia page because I thought if I was feeling this wonder and appreciation of bees, other people would. And for me, where I grew up and the type of friends I had, no one was interested in insects and thought I was a bit of a weirdo for being interested in insects.
Well, I've known Simon for 25 years. I would say he's definitely an eccentric person. He has a different cosmic view of the world. He has a profound connection to nature. He's always surfed and fished and dived. And bees are kind of an extension of that.
Saving the bees comes down to nearly all of us and the decisions we're making. Oh, do we know where our honey's coming from? Are we supporting local businesses?
In 2014, Simon started posting about the welfare of bees on his group Save the Bees Australia.
I'm amazed that this little machine has given me a berth in the Supreme Court. That this post in itself has had 58,000 shares and 3 million views.
He caught the public's attention, but he was now also in Capilano's sights. The company tried to shut him up, launching legal action.
Here you've got a corporation earning so much money out of honey, and they're not defending bees. Capilano honey have caused a lot of grief in my life.
The court battle has been going on for 3 years, and it's taken a toll.
I've got a son, Oscar, he's 8 years old. So nearly for half of his life now, I've been in a court battle against Capilano Honey. This challenge, it's kept me broke and really low income. And Oscar's mum and I were separated. And she couldn't pay her rent anymore. And if this wasn't going on, I think I could have provided Oscar's mum with a roof over her head and electricity. And in that time, she got to a low point and she became homeless for a little bit. And then 3 weeks after that, she was in hospital and hit her head and died. I think if the court case wasn't going on and if Capilano and me were able to agree earlier on, I'd wake up and think maybe Georgia would still be alive now.
He's got a very gentle soul, but he's always had this history of being argumentative. So if you get in a battle with him, he can be lockjaw, you know.
Right, now a little bit in here.
one stage I walked into court and I was representing myself, so I felt quite insecure about the experience. And the barrister walked up to me and he said, "What are you doing here? Everyone's going to laugh at you in here. You're going to be a fool." And I was intimidated.
All right, just a little bit of smoke again.
Capilano isn't commenting on the case while it's before the courts. Up until now, Simon has been representing himself, but he's since crowdsourced enough money for a legal team.
Now that you've got a legal team in Melbourne, you actually have put on a defence. I'll be following up with interest, Simon, as we all will be down here. I mean, you really do have a lot of community support.
And Simon no longer feels alone.
I feel vindicated in many ways. What decision comes through the court case, for me, I can rest now knowing that what I was saying was true and that the beekeepers around Australia are going to benefit in the long run.
Well, we can hold this bee because this is the drone bee.
Yes!
And the only role they've got is really to mate
with the queen. And then they die.
And then they die.
Fun fact, penis blows up.
I hope Oscar, when he grows up, realises that he should fight for what he believes in. And he should follow his intuition. He should enjoy life and celebrate life.